out there. Happy Friday. It's a gorgeous day today on this long weekend. It's the August long weekend. It's here. Yay. You got to get your chisel in first though. Check in and see if we're going to get anyone coming on live today. And then I'll tell you what you need and we'll get you started. All right, so chisel is ahead to training workout. So strength training, building those muscles. We're gonna target every major muscle group in the body. Okay, so it's a great workout. Let me know if you can hear my voice. And those of you that are out there watching, that would be super helpful. All right, guys, you need light, medium, and heavy weights today. As you can see, I got a lot of weights because I have access to a lot of weights, and I know most of you don't. So just grab what you have, have them close by, and that way you have options. So you can go heavier if you need to, you can go lighter when you need to. We also need gliders. How could I forget those? All right, we're using gliders today. So if you don't have a set of gliders, what I suggest for alternatives is if you're using, if you're on a carpeted surface, then use paper plates or plastic plates. If you're working on a hardwood surface, then use washcloths. Okay? So, and if you tried it and it doesn't work for you, that's fine too. I will be telling you what you can do without gliders. So it's not necessary to do the class. We're gonna be doing our leg work with the gliders, but you can easily do it without. So light, medium, heavy weights are pretty much whatever you got, a mat and some gliders. That's all you need today. You need lots of energy. All right, grab a water bottle, have that handy, and then you are ready to go. Okay, let's get you warmed up. Roll your shoulders. Oh, I need to turn the music up for you. All right, if my music isn't loud enough, grab some your own music, turn the volume up, get motivated. All right, roll them forward. Open and close. Opening through the chest. If you're out there working out with me today, give me a hello so I know who's out there with me. I know that there's lots of you that stop in and watch for a second or two and then head off for your day. I'd love to hear from you too. Twist side to side. Oh, can you hear my back cracking? Good. All right, we're gonna go into some squats and we're gonna lift one knee and twist over the knee. Squat and then other way. Pushing through the heels, sitting back. Making sure our core is engaged. Good, now we're gonna roll your right hip in a big circle, switch, roll the other. Take that leg, big circle, full range of motion through the hip joint. Keep going. Hey Brianne, good to have you here. What's up? This class makes your weekend. It makes my weekend too to have you with me. That's good to know. I love that. Good. We're going to go back into those squats. Ready? Squat and lift. Keep those shoulders pulled back. Two more. Awesome. Okay, let's go into a lunge. Right leg forward, left leg back. And do some bicep curls here. Imagine you've got weights in your hands. Good, let's do eight more here. Bending both legs, equal weight on both feet. Four, three, two, and one. Switch other leg. Nice stretched out lunge, hands up. Yes, push through that heel, firing up the glute. Good job, step touch. We're gonna go side to side. Just get that heart rate going a little bit here before we get to work. Now ham curl. Open the arms. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Yes, okay, warm-up is over. Time to work. So today, gliders. We're gonna be doing gliders with our legs today. So we're gonna be doing a leg segment with gliders or without. I will tell you what to do without if you don't have them. Then we're gonna do two circuits of two exercises for our upper body, okay? Then we're gonna go back to legs and gliders. Then we're gonna do two more mini circuits with upper body exercises. Finish off with gliders, and then it's over. And you're good to go for the weekend. Okay, so gliders, get either a washcloth, a paper plate, depending on the surface that you're working on. Now, if you got a glider or a substitute, you're gonna put it under your right foot, okay? And you're just gonna, we're gonna do little skates out here. If you're not working with gliders, your foot just steps out wide and then in, out and then in, okay? Now I'm gonna use the glider. But if you, again, if you don't have one, don't worry about it. Keep going with me. All right, so we're gonna take that right leg out slow and then in. Out, two, in, two. We're kind of working to the beat of the music. So hopefully you can hear my music. If not, just follow me. So push the hip back behind you. You wanna have a good alignment with your hip, your knee, and your ankle. So it's really a one-legged squat you're doing here. We're gonna speed it up, ready? Take it out and in. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth. Good job, we're gonna do lots of reps. If you need a break, you take it, and then join back in when you can. Keeping those shoulders back. Now we're gonna slow it down and we're gonna cross it behind and curtsy. Slow to start, watching that technique, keeping the alignment through that left leg. Lead from your center, belly button pulling in for a tight core. All right, speeding it up. Oh, we gotta love gliders. Love to hate gliders, and I know why. Woo, because they're hard. Great job, keep going. We got four. Three. Two. One more, and then we're switching sides. Ooh. Oh, right, the left leg's gonna get a little break. We're gonna work our right leg now. Out, two, in, two. Again, watching that alignment. The knee, the hip, and the ankle should all be in the same line. Pushing the hip back behind you. Inhale. Change up the tempo, faster. That's it. Eight more here. Then we're gonna move into curtsies. One more. Slow, take it out to the side, cross it behind, hips stay forward, out, cross behind, lead from that core, one more slow, then we're speeding them up. All right, faster. Can you feel that right glute? Woo. Good job. Keep pushing. Woo. Two to go. One more. Shake out those legs. Okay, we're gonna be done with the gliders for a little bit. So just put them off to the side. All right, our first circuit, we're gonna start with some bicep work. So let's go through each. I'm not gonna preview the whole circuit because it's just two exercises. So just grab dumbbells for bicep curls to start. Don't worry, you don't have to commit to what you grab first. You can always switch it out. All right, you're gonna have your left arm anchored here by your side at 90 degrees. And your right arm is gonna be moving. Are you ready? Let's go. Exhale up and inhale down. Lead from the core, then take it to the extremities. Get that mind-muscle connection with the biceps. Think about that muscle. Imagine the movement of that muscle. Switch arms. Exhale as you're lifting that weight. Deep breath out. You're doing awesome. Two more this arm. Then we're switching sides again. All right, left arm at 90, right arm is moving. Halfway done. You can always grab lighter weights. Woo. Pushing yourself out of your comfort zone. That's what this class is all about. If you want to see those gains from your strength training, you gotta get out of that comfort zone to find them. All right, right arm at 90, left arm. Eight of them and then you're done. Four more, you can do it. Good job. All right, grabbing a little bit lighter. You Okay, I'm going to use 10s for this one. I might move down to 8s though. All right, we're going to do reverse flies. First one, your thumbs are pointed down. Second one, palms are pointed down. And third one, thumbs are pointed up. You're just going to keep alternating between those. Yeah, I think I might go down to 8s. Make sure that you can do this completely hinged over so gravity's on our back. All right, let's go. Alternate the direction that your thumbs are pointing with each one. Abs are tight. Support that lower back here. Working our back muscles, some posterior delts. How you doing? This one's a tough one. If you need to go lighter, go lighter. 10 seconds. And rest. Wow. All right, we're going back to biceps. One more set of each one. I went a little long on that last bicep set, so we're gonna keep it a little shorter this time. Anchor that left arm, ready? Right arm is moving. Shoulders are pulling down from the ears. Controlling that dumbbell as it comes down. Four more on this arm. Two to go. All right, are you ready to move the left? Anchor the right. Four more, and that's all we're gonna do on this set. Four. Three. Two. One. And rest. Whew, okay, one more set of those reverse flies. Shake out those hands. Starting in four, three, two, go. Thumbs down, then palms down, and then thumbs up. Every one of them though, you're focusing on pulling the shoulder blades to your spine, bracing the abdominals. Which one do you feel harder? The thumbs up or the thumbs down? The middle one is the easier one. I find the thumbs down the hardest. Okay, you're using more of your posterior delts. And mine are obviously weak because I really struggle with that thumbs down one. Couple more. And rest. Good job, circuit one done. All right, shake it out. Whew. Give the arms a little stretch. How are you doing out there? Are we still doing good? Okay, we are going down to the mat for our next circuit. So get your mat handy. Slow push-ups, guys. Okay, that's your first exercise. We're gonna just do it together. Make sure you can see me. All right. I like to have my arms a little wider when I'm targeting my chest, and then when I do my triceps, I go underneath my shoulders. All right, we're gonna stay on our knees because we're gonna be going very slow, which makes them exponentially harder. You're gonna go at my tempo, okay? You ready? Nice and slow. Take it down, two, three, four, and up, two, three, four. Down, two, three, touch the floor, up, and reach the top. Exhale as you come up. Now make sure you're moving through the whole push-up. Don't come up for two counts and then rest for two counts. You're moving the whole time. And then as soon as you touch, you're lifting up, up, up. You reach the top and you're moving down. So there's no rest point. Oh, are these feeling harder than a regular push-up? They should be. Changing the tempo and going slow burns those muscles right out. Good job. Two more. Down, two, three, four, up, two. Keep those abs in tight. Nice straight body from your head to your knees. One more. Woo! Yes. Okay, that's set number one. Set number two. Grab a dumbbell for overhead tricep extensions. We're gonna be on our knees. You're gonna drop it down and you're gonna press. All right, I'll give you a second to get your dumbbell. And again, you can change it out at any point. Okay, are you ready? Lift it up and let's go. Down. Now you can hold the dumbbell like I'm holding here, or you can try, if you want, holding it on each end like this. It does not matter, whichever one's gonna feel the best for you. Full extension at the top, squeeze those triceps as straight as you can. Your triceps are working on your push-ups, so these are gonna be really tough. One more. And rest. Okay, shake them out. Quick recovery. Then we're doing one more set of slow push-ups. On our knees. Hands out to the side. Drop the hips so they're in line with the rest of your body. Okay, and let's go. Drop, two, three, right, we're going slow. And up, two, three, reach the top. Down, two, three, touch the floor. Ooh, can you feel those triceps already? Inhale on the way down. Exhale, up, two, three, four. Down, two, three. Four, bracing those abdominals. Keep yourself moving through the whole push-up. I know it's really tempting just to fall to the floor and rest for a couple seconds. You wanna keep moving, keep moving. Two more. You can do this. I've got faith in you. Keep it going. Shoulders pulling down from your ears. Down, two, three, four, up. Oh, let's do one more for good luck. Take it down, two, three, and up, two, three. And there you go. Second set of those done. Quick little stretch. Shake out those arms. Whew, my glasses are fogging up already. Shake them out. Grab your dumbbell. Let those triceps recover a little bit. Okay, and go. Oh, does that dumbbell feel like 50 pounds? Mine's starting to get there. Think about those triceps. Get your mind-muscle connection. recruit as many muscle fibers into that muscle as you can. Keep it going, keep it going. Oh, 10 seconds. Fight to keep going right to the end. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice work. Woo. All right, done with that circuit, you guys. Stretch out your arms. We're moving on to legs and gliders again, giving the upper body a little breather. Clean up my area here. I make such a mess when I'm doing my weightlifting. Okay, so gliders. You're gonna need just one glider again, but we are gonna work some biceps with the gliding. So grab probably one of your heavier weights because your biceps are strong. Even though they are tired, we've done a lot of work already with them. All right, you're gonna put the glider under your right leg. You're gonna slide that leg out to the side, do a side lunge, bend over the glider, reach that hand towards the foot, bring it here, and then you're gonna do a back lunge as you do a hammer curl, okay? I know, lots going on that one. We've done this exercise before, so it should look familiar. If you do chisel with me regularly. All right, are you ready? Toes are forward, right leg's gonna slide out to the side. Let's go. Reach in and curl. Work at your own pace. Make sure those shoulders stay back. We're never rounding out our back. Make sure you got a heavy enough dumbbell to feel those biceps. Control the weight, so don't let the dumbbell swing there. Now, oh, if you don't have a glider, I should have shown you that, but you just basically step out, step in, and then step back into a lunge. This one's an easy one to do without the glider. Couple more. Good job. One more. Okay. Switch arms and legs. 5 seconds to start. 3, 2, 1. Lead from your core, belly button to the spine. Shoulders back, controlling the dumbbell. Flat back as you go out into that side lunge. Breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth. Couple more. You can do it. Three, glider off to the side. Shake out those legs and arms. Give me a thumbs up if you're still out there working hard with me. Okay. Now, single double rows. So you're gonna get a little bit heavier. We're gonna hinge over. One arm row, the other arm row, both arms row. And just go through that. Then we're gonna go to our lightest weights for a shoulder series that, again, if you've been doing chisel with me for a while, you will definitely recognize it. Okay, guys, grabbing your heavier weights. You can always get lighter if you need to. Let's really push our limits today, but stay safe while you're doing it. All right, ready? And single, double. Mentally targeting the rhomboids, the mid traps, pulling those shoulder blades down into your back pockets. Nice neutral spine. Squeezing the spine with the shoulder blades. Brace your abdominals to support the lower back. Only two sets of these. I know they're long sets. You can take those breaks if you need to. 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, guys, shake out your arms. Grab your light weights. All right, we're heading right into it. Arms at 90 degrees. Slow. Rotate the palms. Press. Nice and slow. And down. Bring them together. Open. Keep those elbows up at shoulder height. Rotate. Elbows stay up. And bring them together. Okay, we're going to go a little faster. Up for two. Ready? Up. Two. Press. Down. Elbows in. Rotate. And again, slow, just like that. Up for two, up, two. Elbows in. Okay, we're gonna go faster, up to tempo, let's go. Up, rotate, press, bring them in. I love this one, not only because it works every part of the shoulder, but it's also a distraction from all the work we're doing. Because you gotta think about, where are my arms moving to? And keeping up with the pattern. So it's a good distraction. Great job, pull those shoulders down from the ears. One more. Okay, back to those rows. Grabbing your heaviest ones now. Shake out those arms. All right, starting in 5 seconds. Neutral spine, three, two, one. Single, double. Bracing the abdominals. Pulling the shoulders down from the ears and the shoulder blades to the spine. Lengthen through the back of the neck. 15 seconds, you got this. Five seconds, make them count. Three, two, one. Whew. Put them down. All right, give those arms a little shake. Going back into the shoulders. Light weights. Hands at nine, arms at 90s, ready? Up for two. Up, two, rotate. Press. Elbows in. Rotate, keeping the elbows up and down. Just like that again. Ready? Up. Controlling everything. Just like that again. Core's in tight. We don't want an archy back here. Okay, we're gonna take it up to tempo. Ready, go. Great job. Fight through the burn. When you feel that technique going, grab lighter, or if you don't have lighter, take the weights out of your hand and just lift the weight of your arms. Going just a little bit longer. One more, that's it. Bring it down. Yes. All right, stretch out those arms. Woo. Oh, how are those shoulders? Shake them out. Give them some recovery time. All right, we're doing another circuit of upper body. So we're gonna do some cross body curls here. So the hands are kind of out like this, out from your body, so you're working a little bit of anterior shoulder. Curl, curl, okay? You just bring in that dumbbell up to the other shoulder. So that's your first exercise, and then we'll go through the other one together. I won't preview it first. All right, I think I'm gonna go a little heavier. And then I can always go lighter, so that's my suggestion for you as well. All right, ready? Go ahead. Keep the weights off your legs. That's gonna make the anterior deltoid have to do a little extra work. Don't swing the weight. So we don't want this. Okay? Keeping the elbow in one spot and just bringing the dumbbell up towards the opposite shoulder. Halfway. Lifting heavy enough that you can feel those arms. By this point in the workout, nothing should feel easy. Control it coming down. Use the negative or the eccentric part of that contraction. Four, three, two, rest. Okay, down on your mat, on your back, we're gonna do a little combo here. Focusing on chest and tricep. All right, so this is what it's gonna look like. All right, we're gonna do a fly first. You're gonna open the arms out to the side. Then you're gonna bring them up, straight up from the shoulders. You're gonna drop them to the shoulders and extend. Do another fly, and this time do a press. So the elbows come right beside your body, touch the floor, and press up, and then repeat. Fly, extensions, and so on. Okay, ready? Again, switch out the weight if you feel like you cannot successfully complete this. Starting in 5 seconds. Palms together, All right, let's go. Open them out. Bring them up. Touch the shoulders by bending the elbows. Open up again. Now a press. Bringing the arms close to the body and press. Fly. Shoulders. Fly. And press. Mentally targeting our triceps and the chest. Controlling the weights, never letting momentum take over the exercise. How you doing? One set done. Back up on your feet for cross body curls. Shake out the hands. Ready? Go ahead. And again, control the weight coming back down. Trying to keep the weights off the legs. Keeping the elbow in one spot and then just moving the weight rather than moving the whole arm and swinging the arm. I'm hitting the mic. Hopefully that doesn't shut off the mic. Come on, biceps. Feeling those shoulders as well as you hold your arms away from your body. Five, four, three, two, one. All right, laying down. Tricep and chest series. You can have a couple weights close by so you can start a little heavier and change it out when needed. Ready? Go. Open. Shoulders. And I say shoulders not because we're working shoulders, but because you're aiming the dumbbells to the shoulders for that tricep extension. Tight. Belly button pulling in. Last set of this one. Last set of arms, really. And then we're going to go into our last set of legs with the gliders. Almost done. Ugh. Should be feeling really tough. And rest. Woo! Fabulous job. Stretch out your arms. And then grab one glider. Move the mat out of the way. Actually, grab both. If you're using washcloths, you're gonna roll up one of your washcloths. Okay, so you're gonna roll it up here and just hold on to it in your hand. If you've got plates or gliders, you're just gonna hold one glider in your hand and the other is gonna be under your right foot. We're gonna do Bulgarian lunges. All right, ready? Come with me. Slide that right leg back. Touch the shin with the towel or the glider. All right, so we keep that right leg straight. The one that's on the glider is straight. If you don't have gliders, all right, you're just reaching back, and then I want you to bring the knee in. You're gonna do a sprinter like this if you don't have gliders. Okay? So we don't wanna work our right leg at all. It's all going into that left leg. Right leg is straight. Not a regular lunge. A regular lunge, you have equal weight on both feet. This one, all the weight, or 99% of the weight, is on your front leg. How we doing? We're only gonna do one set of each leg. Two more. Watching that the knee is not wobbling around. You want to point it to your first and second toes. Squeezing the glute. Breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. Good job. Two more. Two more. One more. All right, lay down on your back, on your mat with both gliders. You want to position yourself so your bum comes right to the edge of your mat. Heels on the gliders or washcloths or plates, whatever you're using. If you're not using anything, you're gonna put your feet on the floor and you're gonna grab a heavy dumbbell. Well, I guess it doesn't matter. Whatever dumbbell you want, you're gonna place it on your hips and you're gonna do bridges up and down. All right, for those of us that are working with gliders, okay, heels on the gliders, toes in the air, bum at the edge of your mat. Lift the hips up. All right, we're gonna extend the legs and we're gonna pull them in. Way you go. Your bum is just hovering like an inch or two above the floor. You don't have to lift it super high. Unless you're doing bridges, then you wanna lift as high as you possibly can. Now, if this is too tough, bringing both legs in at the same time, then you're gonna go here. Switching one leg out, then the other. Into your nose, out through your mouth. Woo. Come on, hamstrings. Great job. 15 seconds, that's it. Fight hard. I know these are nasty. No one likes these while they're doing them, just afterwards. 3, 2, give me one more. And rest. Woo. All right. Final exercise of the class. Let me just clear some space. All right. We're going to put the gliders under our toes. So we're gonna be here in a plank and you're gonna gonna bring the knees in and out and drop down and up. And repeat with the other arm. If you don't have gliders, you're gonna bring knee, knee, and then drop down onto your elbow. Okay. Ready to finish off the class? Okay, ready? Go ahead. Tuck in, drop down into a ladder on one arm, bring them in, and then switch other arm. Bracing your abdominals. Pushing. I know this is a nasty thing to do to you at the end of the workout when you're tired, but I know you're tough. You can handle it. Only a few more. Dig deep. One more. Legs. Round your back out. Stretching out your back there. All right. Let me slow the music down. My watch isn't working. Oh, nice deep breaths. Every time you exhale, just relax into your stretch a little bit more. All right, I want you to take your left arm on the outside of that right leg. Take your right arm behind you, kind of push on that right leg and look behind you, stretching up nice and tall. And do the other side. Good. Straighten out the legs. Let's stretch the hamstrings. All right, toes up towards the ceiling. I want you to imagine you're up against a wall. So nice and tall here rather than here. So really force yourself to sit on those sits bones. Now this might be enough of a stretch for you. If it is, then you're just gonna hold it here. If you need a little more, then come forward. Reach for those toes. You can pull the toes towards you to intensify the stretch. Or if you can only get down to your ankles, then try and pull the toes towards you on their own. Okay, trying to keep that nice straight back. That's going to lengthen through your hamstrings a little more. Now just let your body hang over those legs. Cross the legs and stretch out over your legs. Now, if you need more on this stretch, grab hold of your feet and knees and pull yourself down a little bit more to help intensify the stretch, or just reach out like this and relax your body right over the legs. All right, come up and uncross that leg and put the other leg in front and do the same thing here. All right, we're gonna bring the feet together. You're gonna slowly make your way up to a standing position. Please take your time so that you don't get lightheaded. Okay, take your right arm across your body. I hope you guys are able to get outside this weekend, this long weekend. It's supposed to be beautiful weather. We're heading right now, when I get home right now, we're heading off to, what is it, Castle Falls. I've never been there. It looks beautiful. I've seen lots of pictures of it. And my daughter's friends have been there and say it's fabulous. So I'm excited to go do that and do a little jumping into the cold water today. Reach up, or not reach up, look up. Open up the chest and the front of your shoulders. You guys, thanks so much for joining me. You deserve a big hand for all your hard work. All right, have a great long weekend. Leave your feedback. I always love to hear what you think of class and the formats. All right, have a great one. We'll catch you later.